when this blast happened yesterday morning, of course, everybody in this area could feel it. You can see it in the damage to the windows here. But three guys working at Henry's Service Center immediately jumped into action without hesitation.
That's when my wife, Jennifer, heard someone calling from out of the debris, and it sounded like he was trying to push some stuff out of the way.
Well, Paul really saved his life, that he wasn't knocked unconscious. He's, you know, was yelling and made noise. Otherwise, you would have looked at this, and you've seen pictures. It's a flattened building.
Just start pulling all of it off of him, you know. And then when we got cleared, when we were trying to get him out, he was stuck.
We were in about 10 feet of debris, so his head was poking up as we're up on the pile. We're moving to clear out for his body, like Brian said, trying to pull him out.
His leg was pinned, and as we were sitting there pulling more debris, just trying to get, you could see the fire coming in on him.
It was very surreal, so you just jumped into it. And after jumping into it for a second is when you kind of realized and looked around, and like, we're in here with wires. Now, kind of be careful. Don't just grab haphazardly at everything.
And he said, you know, there's two other employees, and they're in the office. So I'm trying to figure out where is the office compared to where he's at.
It was too widespread. It was hard enough just to get where we were at. The fire was beyond him. We didn't hear anything else going on.
One word, hero.
No. We were just there. I don't look at it. These guys knew, you know, he knew what to do.
If you hadn't been there, he might not be alive today.
Could be.
You are a hero.
Thank you.
There were other people that were coming while we were there, so if we weren't there, someone else would have found them.
You were the ones.
Yeah, we were, but that's...
Just three regular guys. They'll fix your car, and they'll save your life. In Wayne, Jim Kurtzner, Local 4.